The Bible to the cross from the cross. Every Bible story has three components. First, God's law. Second, God's compassion. Third, God's miracle. Opening your Bible opens miracles. The Bible as one story is holy enough in our lives. Day 16. Genesis 45-47. The tears of Joseph. Reconciliation between brothers, including Judah and Joseph, was made, and the whole family of Jacob moved to Egypt and settled there with God's leading. First point, the number of people entering Egypt was 70, and 430 years later, the number leaving Egypt was 600,000. Joseph, his father Jacob, and Jacob's fourth son Judah together led their family into Egypt. 430 years later, Moses, along with his brother Aaron and sister Miriam, led the Hebrew nation out of Egypt. When Joseph's family entered Egypt, God had given Egypt 7 years of abundance and later 7 years of famine, which dried out the Nile River. In the process of Exodus, God killed all the firstborns of Egypt and split the Red Sea in half. As such, entering and leaving Egypt involved God's miracles. Second point, Joseph's tears are recorded more than 5 times in the Bible. In the Bible, we see a lot of God's people shedding tears and sweat. Joseph is one of those people. The first was when he cried for help to his brothers when they sold him. The second was 22 years later in Egypt when he was reunited with his brothers. The third was when he saw Benjamin after 22 years. The fourth was after hearing Judah's speech. Whilst hearing Judah's speech, Joseph said 3 things. I'm your brother Joseph. Don't be afraid. And stay in the land of Goshen for 5 years. The fifth was when he saw his father in the land of Goshen. Third point. Joseph's family are invited to Egypt as VIPs. Pharaoh suggests an idea to Joseph, his outstanding political administrator. This was to invite all of Joseph's family and, furthermore, to give them good land to live in. Pharaoh invited all of Joseph's family to come to Egypt as VIPs, and he also offered them the following 3. The first was to take grain to them, bring them back in a carriage, and to give them good land. The second was to give Joseph's 10 brothers a loaf each and Benjamin 5 loaves, as well as 300 pieces of silver. The third was to load Egypt's beautiful goods onto 10 male donkeys and to load grain and bread on 10 female donkeys and send them to Joseph's father Jacob. This was because Joseph had changed the fate of Egypt in the past 9 years. Pharaoh knew that it was in his best interest to make sure that Joseph was in good health and spirits in order to continue his job. Fourth point, entering Egypt was in order to make a nation, and the Exodus was in order to make a country. What was more surprising than Pharaoh's dream or Joseph's dream was Jacob's dream in Beersheba. God gave Jacob the dream of making a nation and also making a country in order to fulfill his vision of blessing all nations. God appeared to Jacob in his dream to tell him about his plan through Jacob's family entering Egypt. After this dream, Jacob wasted no time to go to Egypt. Jacob also told this dream to his son Joseph. Joseph was the one who saw God's plan of 7 years of abundance and 7 years of famine. And Daniel was the one who saw how God changes seasons and raises kings. Jacob told Joseph that their years in Egypt would be 430 years, and Jeremiah told Daniel that their years in Babylon would be 70 years. As such, God's work is done through collaboration with his people. Fifth point, Joseph's preparation for his family's life in Egypt was the land of Goshen, raising of stock and education. The first thing Joseph prepared was the land of Goshen. He was initially offered any land in Egypt. However, he chose the land of Goshen, which he finalized through his five brothers. The second thing Joseph prepared was raising stock. The people of Egypt at the time looked down on raising stock. Knowing this, Joseph intentionally selected raising stock in order to set apart his family from the Egyptians. He knew that intermarrying with the Egyptians would mean that God's plan to multiply Abraham's descendants would not work. The third thing Joseph prepared was education.
I am thrilled that you have downloaded the TonDoc app. The TonDoc app is not like any other app in the world today, as well as in the body of Christ today. Dr. Biyongo Zoe has devoted his entire life to teaching men and women like yourself to understand the entirety of the Word of God as a masterful and beautiful story from Genesis to Revelation. Dr. Zoe is a sought-after speaker worldwide. He's a cutting-edge pastor and leader. He is a renowned theologian and a prolific writer. And you're going to be equipped and energized like never before to understand and apply the Word of God into your life. Again, thank you for downloading the TonDoc app.